Hey, what's up, you guys? So today I just kind of wanted to walk through Timex's growing collection of mechanical and automatic watches. A few years ago, they reintroduced or reissued their 1960s classic, the Marlin. This is a 34-millimeter hand-winding time-only watch with a domed acrylic crystal, and it was very true to the original, and it became very popular. I believe the first version was this champagne-colored dial, but as you can see, the line has grown to include a number of different dial colors, case colors, and it's available on a leather strap, a mesh strap, as well as an optional bracelet at an additional charge. And I think based on the success of this line, we've seen Timex branch out into automatic watches as well, and they've really grown their lineup. If you haven't checked it out recently, there's a more contemporary version of the Marlin at 40 millimeters, and these come in a variety of both dial colors and case colors, and different sets of complication. There's these day-date versions, as well as date-only versions. There's also some time-only versions. There's this really cool, they have a few different Peanuts ones. This one's featuring Snoopy, but there's another one featuring further down Charlie Brown. Moving up in size, they have these 42-millimeter Waterbury automatics, and they're available in a couple of different styles and handsets. And this one is also available on a stainless steel bracelet that looks pretty cool. There's a dive style version of the Navi. Now, these have been available for a while in quartz, but here they're offering at 41 millimeters a line of automatics, and they look very cool. I like the red bezel. I also like this blacked out one. And one of the things you might notice about the hour hand on these, inside the regular indices, they have the 13 through 24 indicators for kind of like that military time. And there's a ring on the hour hand, and as the ring moves past those numbers, you can kind of see what hour you're on because the ring is surrounding it. That's a really cool detail on those. There's a couple open heart watches and a different style of the Waterbury Classic, kind of a different handset at 40 millimeters, and that comes with the date. There's this very special Giorgio Galli. I believe this is a partnership they did with this designer. This is a really cool looking watch. I'd love to see one of these. They have these deep cuts into the side of the case. You can even see there's a jewel that's part of the movement that shows through the front of the case. It has these really cool skeletonized hands and an integrated strap like system. So it's really cool to see, and this one's actually sold out, so it looks like it's doing well. So it's great to see that Timex is kind of exploring the mechanical watch lineups that they're offering and kind of doing some brave and interesting things with this S1 automatic. There is also this very popular M79 automatic, which I think is also currently sold out. They introduced that Q, I think, about a year ago. It was quartz. It had the Pepsi bezel style. I think it was 38 millimeters, very popular. And then they followed it up with this 40 millimeter automatic version with that Batman bezel. And this one is also really cool and also sold out. Don't pay more than retail for these guys. They're going to keep making these. The kind of the same thing happened last year with the quartz version of the Q. There was a lot of people hoarding them and trying to mark them up on eBay, but they're available. Like, Timex is not going to stop making these, so just be patient and you can get one at MSRP from Timex. Now, I've been a little bit hesitant to buy one of these automatic watches. They do not actually indicate what movement they're using. They are 21 jewels and they do hand wind, but I don't believe they hack. So if I had to guess, they're using Miyota 8000 series movements. If anyone knows for sure and I'm wrong, go ahead and please correct me in the comments. But if I had to guess, that's what you're getting here. And they're really cool, but they're a little bit on the expensive end. I'm kind of drawn to the Navi automatic, these dive style ones, and they're 259, which isn't that unreasonable, but if you start to consider like the Orient Komatsu, you can get on a bracelet, and note these don't come on bracelets, with a sapphire crystal and a hacking and hand winding movement for about $200 if you're lucky and you find one on sale. These are a little bit expensive from a value proposition at $259 when you're not getting a bracelet, and I think it's a mineral crystal. So I do want to get one though for the channel and just see if, you know, the case finishing and the wearing experience. And, you know, Timex is a really storied and historical brand, so it's really cool to see them doing mechanical and automatic watch movements. I think before the Marlin, they were only doing quartz, and now they're kind of re-entering this space. The other thing I did notice is they do have sales from time to time. So this Marlin Automatic Peanuts version, which is a popular version, by the way, is currently on promotion for 25% off because it's over $99. So I'm going to keep my eye open on the sale. Maybe if one of these navvies goes on sale, I will grab one for the channel. But I did want to reach out to you guys and ask, has any of you experienced any of these mechanical or automatic movements or watches from Timex? And what was your overall impression of like the value proposition as well as the finishing and just how you enjoyed the watch? So if you have, please leave me a comment in the comments below. As always, if you enjoy this content, please like and subscribe. It really helps the channel. And that's all for now, and I'll see you guys next time.